occupational government, which was act that eventually, which was founded in 1861 under the Lincoln and them put out something. You're not. The U.S. corporation, the occupational government, which was founded in 1861 under the Emergency War Powers Act that eventually came what they call the Libra Code. If you really want to get into it, what really happened was that they forced an agenda. And Lincoln and them put out something to say that the United States federal government, which is a foreign government, to the Republic of the United, excuse me, to the Republic of so-called America, what they call United States of America and General Congress assembled. That's the original preamble government that existed here under the Articles of Confederation, under the Articles of Association. And that government was based on our people.
Right.
Period.
Form of government where you give power of attorney to someone else. And I know all of y'all know this. Representative and republic go together, and a representative must speak for you, and you remain silent. That is a republic. We, amongst the Moors, do not have a republic form of government. We created a republic form of government for someone else.
So when Lincoln came in, he said, we're going to make the Negro and the white man both equal under the federal government. And those of us that was free said, hell no, I'm not going to be equal to the people you just bringing over here as slaves.
Right.
And so we fought a war.
That's what the war was about.
That's what the war was about. The right for the individual estates to maintain a confederacy. And so a white confederacy was founded outside of our original Haudenosaunee Confederacy to fight the white so-called government. And in return, they would receive certain benefits from us. When they lost the war, all the countries, all the states that were going to be let back into the United States had to adopt the 14th Amendment. And if they didn't, they would be burnt down and killed.
Which, the 14th Amendment, which
was? The 14th Amendment, which says that everybody is basically a slave under the federal government, and that involuntary slavery is illegal so long as you're not punished by a crime. So if we can lock you up, you can be a slave legally. And so that created the original so-called Libra Code that was then adopted by the Belgian Conference in 1888, which then led to the deep colonization of Africa. You understand? So what I'm showing you is they use the same code here to break our republic and then force everybody into being citizens of the United States, which means that they are subject to a foreign power, an inferior state, when they were subjects of a foreign power, which was the republic and the empire that was already here. And we can find this, the proof of this, in the letters that were written to the governors by the military general that established the new government that started in 1867. So that means, brothers and sisters, if they didn't create the U.S. citizen mandate until 1871, what were the people that were here prior to the creation of the U.S. citizen? They were Americans, because they were in the republic. So whether you realize it or not, when the Prophet Jew Ali said that I am a true American citizen, he didn't say that he was a citizen of the United States. That's some shit that they flipped up later after they reorganized the Moorish Science Temple in 1938, when they put the traitor, C. Kirkman Bey, in charge. And then he went in and changed it up and brought the Freemasons into it. And it's been all messed up ever since. Now, this don't mean all temples is like that. But I'm saying that all of the black organizations that came after the MST of A were all had the influence and knew that there was an actual way for us to go back to our original state without having to be subjected to being citizens of a country that has labeled us enemy combatants. The other irony is, after the United States switched the jurisdiction and they let everybody back into the so-called new corporate occupational government, they had to leave a way out for those of us that remembered that we had our own steeds.
Right.
So this is where, when they say founded them for the republic, which it stands, one nation.
Mm-hmm.
Did it say anything about a democracy? It doesn't. Because democracy means a demonized government, a demonstrative government, meaning it's not real. Mm-hmm. It's under a colorable law. So anything that's colorable is not real. But in a colorable law-based society, You have to be a color for them to have jurisdiction. So here comes black. This is why you got to be black. Because that's what they were prior to the conflict. And then what they did was they just switched you under what's called the Emancipation Proclamation, which emancipate does not mean to free. It means to change ownership. So that means the ownership was switched where the so-called
the
whites became black.
That's the etymology of that word.
That's right. To in the Latin, emancipato.
Wow.
So when you have these Moors out here and these blacks out here purposely miseducating people, telling them that they're citizens of the United States, when they know damn well, or they should know damn well, that in the Republic, you can't be a citizen of the United States and American at the same time. You gotta be one or the other. In order to be an American, you have to have a nationality. That's why people with the nationalities go far in America. Italian Americans got their own community, right?
Right.
Irish Americans got their own community, right? Indian Americans got their own community, right?
Indeed.
What do black Americans have? A ghetto. Prison. You think that's by chance? No, that's by design. Because they know you niggas don't read, and they know that somebody like me kicking this to you, you're gonna try to find something wrong with me to not listen to me. So I say keep doing that. Don't believe me. You dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Don't believe me. Don't follow through in what I'm saying. Don't research the letter that the last governor of North Carolina wrote, the last true Republican governor of North Carolina wrote the military guard that was gonna come and kill him if he didn't give up the seat. That means then that we have not been under a real government since 1861. That's why we walked out the Congress. Mm. And we were supposed to come back and reconvene it. But they established a dictatorship, and then when Lincoln wanted to get us out and put us back under the thing through the Freedmen's Bureau, they killed him. And then what happened? They started to then extend the jurisdiction all over the world. So they took the same code to do what they did here, brought it over to Africa, and put it into the what they call the Belgian Conference of 1888. And you see what happened with all that? Mm. Another thing, when these so-called blacks is on TV and they showing you pictures of Leopold and the Congo and all that stuff that happened out there, and they show you with the Moor with the feathers on,
right,
and brutalizing the Africans.
And they say those were the traitors, right?
Come on now, Moor. This is how you know Negroes don't read. One, because those people that you see in those places had already been in conflict before Leopold got there. And those people, all that happened in Eastern Africa. So those were Somalians, those were Kenyans, those were Ugandans, those were Ethiopians, Eritreans, and Congolese. And specifically, they were Bantu, Swahili, and Hutu peoples, mm-hmm. who were at war with each other for so long that when Leopold came, he said, I'm gonna hook up with these blacks to break down these blacks. Mm. And just in case, to throw shade on the Moroccans, put this hat on. That's why when you look at the fezzes that they wear, they don't look like these.
No, they don't.
We don't wear fezzes with writing on it. We ain't Shriners. I mean, we Shriners in the Moorish aspect sense, but we don't put on no aprons. We don't write nothing on our fezzes. Because what they don't tell you, Shriners, is that the name on the top of the fez represent the Moor that used to own you. Islam. Yep. But they won't tell you that.
Word?
Yeah, because you niggas think you're doing something when you're walking down with a fez that's tacked down. A fez that's tacked down is like when deviants put what they call penis clamps on themselves to inhibit their manhood. Only women wear aprons and cooks. Yeah. You dig what I'm saying?
Indeed.
We didn't do that. We gave that to them because they were so savage at one point, they ripped off their loincloths and was naked. So we gave them an apron to cover their nakedness, to give them some shame. And once we walked them 2,200 miles to the six hills of West Asia, they ripped it off and ran up into the hills. That's why you got a lot of them is being born with tails and stuff to this day. Don't believe me? Look it up. So what I'm saying, bro, and what I'm saying to the people is, they've been mind controlling you for so long that they put you against yourself, and anybody that comes to help bring you out of it, they castigate and make you castigate them. So they want you to believe again that Moors enslaved all of the Africans, when the people that was over there was not Moroccan, they was not Al-Moroccan, they was not Moorish American, they were not of the Maghreb Al-Aqsa, meaning the Morocco of the farthest west.
Indeed.
They were Eastern Africans who spoke African dialects. So the Africans sold themselves into slavery and brutalized themselves in the Congo. And if you don't believe me, do the knowledge. There was nobody speaking Arabic, no so-called Moors that was out there speaking Arabic and all that. Those was all Africans brutalizing each other on behalf of the European Leopold.
Dr. Ben was our leader. He wasn't just the teacher of the now, he was the leader of the whole group. Dr. Jeffries didn't do nothing Dr. Ben didn't approve of. That's the way we were. Clark didn't do nothing out of Purimi that Ben disapproved of.
There came a time in 1506, after we lost power in Spain, the Africans ruled Spain from 711. We were calling ourselves Moors, M-A-U-E-R-S, then M-O-O-R-S. We were calling ourselves Moors.
Rahm Emanuel Jewell, one of the first things he issued from his desk was a proclamation telling the real history of the North Gate. You know, too many people weren't too happy about that. Now, I'm going to show you very basically how most of us have been miseducated quite easily, right? By letting, rather than convince you or to try to convince you, I'll have you read it, all right? So now she's going to a dictionary, she's going to read black to all the adults and the children who must compete in this world.
Black, blacker, blackest. Abbreviation, I guess that stands for. BLK. Mm-hmm. Number one, being of the darkest, a chromatic visual value.
Now, stop. Now, a scholar would automatically recognize the flaw. Mm-hmm. A grammatic, one who understands orthology would immediately recognize that she violated. But I know it's because of the training.